high five because we haven't got a clapper board.
What was that? Did I oh no. Did I custard pie? Oh, that's so bad. Here with Raging Speedhorn. It's 2021.
Rock and metal is back. So of course,
yeah.
Corby's Hellraisers have to be back as well. How are you doing, guys?
Yeah, good.
Very well.
Are you happy to be back?
Oh, yeah.
So yes.
You can leave it somewhere in the middle and we'll pick it up and I'll bring this in here as well. That'll stop you having to do all this business.
Sorry, I feel like Terry Morgan.
Yeah. Yeah, I was going to say, or like Michael Parkinson or something. We're showing our ages here. What time are you playing? So you're on the Sophie, aren't you?
Yeah, 5:30. 5:30.
Should have been on main stage, but 5:30 on the Sophie.
Yeah, well, the Sophie, the sound of the Sophie at the moment is absolutely superb.
Oh, it's a great awesome. Stage. Yeah.
It'll sound amazing.
Yeah, we love Sophie, the sound's amazing. Yeah, in some ways we prefer it because of the sound, it's an awesome stage.
That's it. Well, because open air, you can't stop the sound blows around a little bit on
yeah.
the main stage.
It's a bit windy today.
Yeah, very windy. So is this first show back since pandemic?
Third show back.
Yeah, 2 weeks ago we did Bournemouth. Which was our own show. That sold out, so that was a great way to come back. And then the night after we did The Yard in Cornwall with Orange Goblin and Phil Campbell, Massive Wagons and all
oh,
that.
Cool.
It was a great,
yeah, it's awesome.
Great night, absolute great night, banging. Yeah. So it was a great way to come back to the live scene.
Because Speedhorn's newer sound fits in with those bands, because things have got a bit doomier and a bit sludgier in the world of Speedhorn, wouldn't you say?
I got a bit rockier.
Yeah, I think I'd say.
I'd say
more DC more than anything.
Yeah.
I mean, like, every band's got to change. You can't keep on
absolutely.
Just doing the same old shit.
Cause unless people, you're Slayer.
You know, unless you're, yeah, or not shit, actually, AC/DC, but, you know, but we just need, I mean, it's all different members now, bar me and Frank, you know, so we just have to change a bit, I think. You know, like, to be fair, like, me and Frank, not saying we did, but, like, me and Frank wrote quite a bit of that record between us, because we didn't have a band.
Yeah.
So me and him did it, a lot of it, and then when Dave and, because obviously Jim had left as well, so it was only us two at one point.
Is Jim back now?
Jim's
back.
Yeah, Jim's back. So
he just had to go for a sleep for an hour.
He's had
some bad shit, but like that's the same. It's always the same with Speedhorn. It's like there's always stuff going on behind the scenes. It's hard to keep us all together, but this time we've got a good unit. It feels good. It feels good again. So
are you going to be unleashing today? Is there going to be some madness on the stage? And
hopefully,
yeah. I mean, the set is all geared up, but it's all just our singles.
Oh, cool.
So it's just no fucking about. Sorry if I'm not.
No, you're allowed to swear.
No fucking about. It's just full on. Let's have it. Party time.
It's been so long. Let's have a party with all the bangers everyone knows.
Yeah,
let's go out there.
Yeah, looking forward to it.
Yeah.
And a saucy little cover as well.
Yes.
Oh.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, I'll have to come and see and find out what it is.
We've never ever rehearsed.
Oh my God. So
we haven't rehearsed this set.
It's like it could be really chaotic then.
Yeah. It always is with
That's
us.
What it is,
oh, fantastic! Yeah, yeah, yeah. You
know, speed on
God, if we went on there being as tight as a duck's ass, people would hate it.
Yeah. Well, it wouldn't be speed on, would it? Really.
No, that's the thing. It's like it's got to be that. You know.
Yeah.
I like riding.
Like that. Yeah, yeah. On the seat of your pants.
Yeah.
Or the seat of someone else's pants.
Yeah,
that's even better.
Yeah,
isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, yeah.
So what's after Bloodstock then?
Wild Arts next 2 days, isn't it?
Yeah.
Exeter and From with the Wild Arts.
We've got something else on as well, haven't we? I can't remember. We've got quite a lot of stuff on, so it's hard to remember.
Has it now got to the stage? Because nothing happened for a year and a half. Now everything's just like boom. And
I think the problem was we got loads of stuff, and it all got postponed and moved, and then postponed and moved again. And we're kind of like, is that happening this year? Is it next year now? Or it gets a bit. I mean, my diary's changed about 5 million times.
Yeah.
I'm still like looking at it. Is that one still going ahead, or is that next year now?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
We've got something on the 12th. Oh, we've got that September in Leicester. That festival in Leicester we're doing with Orange Goblin.
Oh yeah, Uprising.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, we've got Uprising. Then we've got the MMH with the Wild Arts. And on the same night, we're playing Leeds. We're playing in Birmingham with the Wild Arts. and Leeds 2 hours later for Damnation.
Who do you think you are, Phil Collins? Is this some kind of Live Aid thing? What's happening with that? I mean, it's not quite Wembley and Philadelphia, but still, but,
You know, like, you can't... With this band, I feel... Well, it's my fault, because I say yes to stuff about doing it. But, you know, like, I always say yes to stuff before they even know about it. And then I go to them and say, we're doing this. And we just have to get around it. Because, like, that's just the way bands always been. Like, you know, our manager always said, like, if you want to be in a band, you have to be in a band.
Yeah.
No cancelling, no nothing. Like, you just you do it, and that's it.
Because it's graft. Life, if you do the graft, you can have the laugh, really, isn't it? It's all right to be going mad and having a great giggle, but you have to have put in that that graft in the first place.
I think we've done enough for that over the 22 years.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, but we're still here. As I said to someone the other day, it's like, we're still here, still doing it after 22 years. Not many bands can say that from our era.
Yeah. So no, definitely not. You
know, so I'm quite happy that we're still getting to play these festivals.
Well, if I remember, you know, back when you guys played Total Fest back in 2000 or whatever it was, with, you know, people like Stamping Ground and Earth Tone Nine, and like you say, a lot of the other bands have gone by the wayside, or they've split up and then come back after a few years, but you guys have still kept going.
Yeah, so. I mean, like, we had a few years off because I think we were just going a bit mental, because we just toured so much for 10 years. Needed some time off.
And people moved away, didn't they?
From... I mean, like, all of us don't live in... None of us live in the same town.
No.
So, like, I live in Wales. He lives in Stafford.
Yeah.
The other boys live in Stoke. Frank still lives in Corby. So we're just everywhere. So, yeah. But the thing is, I think it helps us more because we're not in each other's pockets all the time.
Yeah.
So when we get together, it's just...
Yeah, when we get together, it's like, boom.
It's just happy times, isn't it?
But that's a different kind of band, though, isn't it, to the one that you had at the beginning, where you were a bunch of lads who grew up together you know, you were a gang.
Yeah.
And then you have to evolve into something else, which is a working professional unit. Yeah, and then you can still act like a bunch of idiots when you get together to rehearse or play shows.
Yeah.
So
I mean, like, to be like, it's quite weird with Speedhorn now. It's like, me and Frank are probably the worst out of all of them.
Yeah,
because we like having a good time, but like the rest of them are like, what the fuck are them two idiots doing now? But like, you know, that's sort of our mindsets are different. And the thing is because I deal with the day-to-day stuff with the Speedhorn. When I come away, I just like to just be in a band. I've done the stuff before I have to go away. So when I go, and we've got a tour manager who deals with all that of us shit when we're away. So yeah, it's getting to a good place now in the band.
And you, of course, your business is a tour bus business, isn't it? So during the pandemic, things were looking really dicey.
It's been horrendous. But the thing is like you can't sit down and cry about it because everyone else is in the same position as you are. So it's like, well, we'll just have
to get on with it. Yeah.
And luckily, we released a record. So that, and like I started managing the band again, just as it came out. So that's just been, but that's a full-time job in itself to manage Speedhorn, because like there's stuff going on all the time.
There is, yeah.
So we are a professional band, really.
Yeah.
But don't get paid for the fucker.
Yeah.
But, you know, that's
imagine if you got paid for the amount of work you put in.
It'd
be amazing,
wouldn't
it?
We do. We're lucky in that. Hard work, especially for a band like us, who are like, we're not commercial in any sense of the word, so to be where we are and be still being able to do it, I think it's quite a cool thing, really. I wish Iron Monkey was still around, but the real Iron Monkey,
the real Iron Monkey indeed. Oh, Johnny,
but, I know, legend, but I mean, we're probably the only band from that kind of it who's still going, really, which is quite insane, even though we were sellouts to a point. But hey, here we go. Hey ho.
Well, guys, have an awesome show later on. Thank you so much
for stopping by.